I am here to give you practical demo of your chemistry practical paper 1 of physical chemistry. Now in physical chemistry there are 4 practicals which we are going to take your demo. So out of that 4, 2 are potentiometry. One is potentiometric titration, second is Daniell-Sell experiment, third one is conductometric titration, and fourth one is paper chromatography. So today we'll start with the conductometric titration. So just I'll show you, already PDF is shared with you, so go through that. I'll tell you the aim of the experiment: determination of amount of strong acid in given solution by titration with strong base using conductometer. So very first I'll tell you about conductometer. This is your conductometer. It gives or measures the conductance of the solution. So this is a conductivity cell. This is stirrer on off button, and this display shows you the reading of the solution, that is reading of the conductance of the given solution. Now just I'll tell you how to standardize it. There is an inbuilt standardization method for conductometer. So just one knob is given over here, you have to shift on that mode. Your conductometer should give you the reading 1 on the display. So it indicates that your conductometer is standardized. Now just we'll shift on the same, our reading mode. So this gives you the conductance of the solution which is filled in a beaker. Now how to use the conductometer, that I tell you. Very first you have to wash the conductivity cell for number of times with conductivity water. So already I have filled the conductivity water. Just I'll show you how to give the washing. Remove this water. Add new conductivity water and dip your conductivity cell in it. Repeat this process 4 to 5 times so that whatever the traces of previous solution are there, that will be completely removed. So in this way, I have washed the conductivity cell for number of times. Now your experiment is your simple HCl-NaOH titration, which we are going to carry out normally by using volumetric method, by using phenolphthalein indicator. But same experiment we are going to carry out by using conductometer. So you have to take the burette, wash it, rinse it and fill it with NaOH. So I have already filled the burette with NaOH. Now HCl unknown solution is supplied to you in a 100 ml standard measuring flask. So dilute it up to the mark by using distilled water. So I have already diluted it, and then pipette out the 10 ml of it in a beaker. So I have already pipetted out. Now what you have to do, you have to remove this conductivity cell from your conductivity water and you have to dip it in your supplied solution, as well as you have to put the stirrer in it. Now you can see that your conductivity cell is not properly dipped. So to the same solution, you have to add 10 ml of conductivity water. So see, I am adding 10 ml of conductivity water to it. If necessary, add 10 ml more. So just I am adding my 10 ml more. I am adding 5 ml more. See whether your conductivity cell is dipped properly or not. Now you can see that it is dipped properly. Now you have to note down the reading which is shown on the display, that is 14.10. It is given in millisiemen. We are going to write the readings in C cement. So multiply the reading by 10 raised to minus 3. Okay. So your first reading or reading for 0 ml addition of NaOH is 14.10 into 10 raised to 3 millisievert. Now what you have to in cement. Now what you have to do? You have to start adding NaOH from the burette. When you are going to add NaOH from the burette, you have to keep in mind that the solution is properly stirring or not. Now see, I am going to add the 0.5 ml NaOH from the burette. So when 0.5 ml of NaOH is added, you can see the reading is changed. That is, reading is decreased. So note down this reading for 0.5 ml addition. In this way, you have to keep on adding 0.5 ml of NaOH. See, I have added next 0.5. That is 1 ml of NaOH. Reading is decreased from 14 to 12.60. So in this way, you have to keep on adding the reading. You have to keep on adding 0.5 ml of NaOH. And every time you have to note down the reading. See, for convenience, now I will add directly 2 ml. As you keep on adding the NaOH, the conductance will go on decreasing. Then a point will come when instead of decreasing, conductance will start increasing. So just will add 0.5, and you can see the changes in the reading. It is still decreasing. You can see the reading is decreasing. Now you can see that there is a little increase in the reading. Okay. So just I keep on adding. Now you can see reading is increasing little bit. So just I continue adding 0.5 ml of NaOH from the burette. This process you have to continue after increasing your reading. That is, you have to continue the titration of more than 5 ml when the reading will start increasing. So in this way, you have to add the NaOH up to the 15 cm cube. And after every 0.5 ml addition, you have to note down the reading. So hence your actual practical work is over. Now when your practical work is over, at that time, remove your burette solution, note down your final reading, and remove your conductivity cell from the given solution and wash it 2 to 3 times with conductivity water and then go for your calculation part. So just I'll show you how to do the calculation part. So this will be your observation table. Observation numbers, volume of NaOH added and conductance in cement. Then you have to plot a graph of conductance against volume of NaOH added. So as you have seen in the experiment that at the starting the readings are very high. As you keep on adding NaOH, the readings will go on decreasing. Then a stage comes when reading starts increasing, and hence you will get V-shaped graph. You have to draw
two straight lines. The intersection point of these two straight line will gives you end point of the calculation. Now I'll tell you why such things are happen. At the starting, only HCl is there, so which is strong electrolyte and completely dissociated. So at the starting, the readings are very high. Your conductance is very high. But as the NaOH is added from the burette, at that time HCl will get converted into salt. Due to this salt formation, that is also a strong electrolyte, but then too conductance will decrease little bit. This decrease in conductance will continue till all HCl gets converted into NaCl or gets neutralized. After that, when you are going to add excess amount of NaOH, at that time NaOH is again strong electrolyte which will dissociate completely, and due to that the reading will start increasing and hence you will get V-shaped graph. The intersection point of these two lines will gives you equivalence point or end point of the titration, and by using this end point you have to do the calculation, that is you have to find out the strength of given acid. So that's all for conductometry.